let's ignore the fact that it's been nearly a year between this tutorial and the last one, so let's just dive right into this. Hello and welcome back to this series I've gotten the most requests to continue, the hydraulic tutorials in PolyBridge 2. This time, we are diving into some of the much more complicated stuff, so this really is not the best place for a new person to start. You're gonna have to understand all the concepts I've gone over in my previous two videos. But enough stalling, let's learn some 180 degree links. We start with our 2 meter square box again. Now you see why I like this thing. It's good for more than just 90s. To rotate 180 degrees, the diagonal corners must change sides. If we cut a section out of the box and lay it flat, we can see this is just a 4 meter move with a joint in the middle. We can easily make a 4 meter move with our perfect 90, so let's build that in. Since this is a copy of our 2 meter square box, we've got a perfect 90 degree link right here, so I'm just going to copy and paste this to extend it out to a 4 meter move. I'll add in the hydro and some bits to keep it rigid, and now we've got a perfect 90 that moves 4 meters. Now this is the part where we have the paradigm shift. Remember how we rotated that diagonal corner out of the box to make it flat? We don't have to rotate it back when we stick the mechanism back onto the box. Now we do have to make some modifications to the box. This corner down here was a fixed point, so we need to delete some pieces and make it rigid. But that's it. That's the lazy 180, or lazy comet 180. I certainly was not the first person to do something like this, but as I was the first person on the PolyBridge server to document it, it was named after me. Thanks, Arglin. Let's build an example with this linkage. So here in my tutorial sandbox world number 3, we are going to solve some arbitrary challenge with the LC180. Since we are rotating 180 degrees, and the pivot point for our guiding arms must be directly in between the start point and end point of our move, we need to measure out and see that, oh, this is a 6 meter segment, so 3 meters is right smack dab in the middle. We're going to construct our guiding arms here, brace them to each other, and put in some supports to keep them upright. Now we just need to build a power source. I'll start with the square, copy one of the edges, copy out the center joint twice, and brace it together. Delete the extra bits that I don't need, and slap a hydraulic on it. All we have to do now is just slam this dude onto the pivot point and connect it to the guiding arms, and there you have it! 180 degree movement! I'll disconnect the road so you can kind of see what's going on here and highlight some joints. However, while the lazy 180 is a relatively strong mechanism, there are some problems with it. It's very jerky and bulky and expensive, but it is very clear what is happening and why this creates a 180 degree rotation. The next mechanism we are going to look at is on the complete opposite end of the spectrum. This is the double 90-180, single hydro variant, which is a stupid name, which is why I like to call it the easy 180, because of how easy it is to build. It's based off taking a perfect 90 and stacking it on top of itself. I had an hour-long conversation in the science channel of the PolyBridge server, and none of us could come up with a simple and understandable way to derive this thing from base concepts or linkages, or even show how the one on the left becomes the one on the right. They're related, but I don't see the connection. So we're just going to skip over that part for now and focus on how to build this thing instead. We'll get back to this issue. So the practical application of the Easy 180 works like this. We start with our box, as usual, connect a hydraulic to the center of it, and attach a beam from the end of the hydraulic to the two corners of the box. One of these corners needs to be pinned in place. We delete the outer half of the box, and that's it. It's so simple and easy to construct, hence the name. The red beam on the output rotates 180 degrees. Let's build this in another example. Here, I've taken that same generic sandbox world and shifted over the top by an arbitrary amount. You're going to follow the same procedure as before, but this time use the tracing tool and fill tool to find our center point of rotation. We add the guiding arms back in like before. Hold them in place. Brace the two guiding arms to each other. And construct our power source. I start with the box again because I'm not 100% sure how I want this to rotate. Since it needs to go clockwise, I decided to put the hydraulic in sideways and pin the lower arm, making attaching the brace between the output and the guiding arm easy. I'm coloring the output red so you can follow it. Now we'll just move this power source back onto the pivot point, hold it in place, and attach our brace. And there you have it, the Easy 180 in action. Now let's pause here for a moment. At this point, the linkage concepts and theory on why they work is getting to be more complicated than the actual construction of the mechanism themselves. You would basically need to have the Polybridge linkage god themselves, Arglin Campling, sit down and write you a thesis paper to derive these linkages. So from this point on, the hydraulic tutorial series is dead. And in its place, we shall begin a new series in partnership with who else but Arglin Campling. We're calling it Kinetic Bridge Basics. We have the foundation of bracing, guiding arms, and simple rotations already in place, so this will focus on how to build and power these new linkages rather than explaining why they work. Though, since I now have Arglin in my pocket, we can do a little bit of that too. Thank you for sticking with this video all the way to the end. The next video in the Kinetic Bridge Basics is going to focus on linear movement, or more accurately, approximate linear movement. We're not quite there yet. But that's everything you need to know about 180s. I hope you found this video useful. You've been watching The Lazy Comic, and I hope you'll keep me in your orbit.